Welcome to ISU Gen Chem Lab Tutorials. In this lesson, we'll cover how to use Excel to graph experimental data. In this example, I've measured the mass of several different volumes of corn syrup to see if there's any relationship between the mass of corn syrup and its volume. The first step is to tell Excel what we want to graph. Notice I've typed in my mass values in the first column, column A, and their corresponding volume values in the adjacent column, column B. Next, we'll select the data by holding down the left mouse button and drawing a shaded box around the two columns of data. Then, with the data selected, click on Insert from the main toolbar. Then under the Insert tab, towards the middle, we have the chart options. And we want to choose the chart option that is on the bottom row center, which is the scatter plot. After choosing it, notice that we now have several different types of scatter plots to choose from. We want to choose the one in the upper left-hand corner, the one that does not try to connect the data points in any way. Now with my plot generated, I can tell that Excel has decided to graph volume on the y-axis because my largest y value is 25.00, which corresponds to my largest volume value. Likewise, my largest x value is 34.501, which matches my largest mass value. To show that explicitly, I want to add axis labels to both the y-axis and the x-axis. To do that, I'll first select the chart by left-clicking somewhere on the chart. Then in the upper right-hand corner, we want to select the plus sign in order to add chart elements. When we select axis titles, we now have text boxes for the y-axis title and also for the x-axis title that we can then edit. Double-click in the text box to highlight it, and then label it with the meaning of the y-axis numbers, including their units, which is volume in milliliters of corn syrup. And the x-axis label should then be mass in grams of the corn syrup samples. I'll also double-click to highlight the title text box of the graph in order to give it some type of descriptive title. So in this example, perhaps linear relationship between the volume and mass of corn syrup, because that seems to be the story this data is trying to tell. In order to quantify this relationship, I'll add a trend line to model the data. I can do this by selecting the chart, choosing chart elements, and at the bottom, selecting trend line. By default, Excel adds a linear trend line, which does seem to model, in other words, match my data fairly well. While still in chart elements, click on the right-facing arrow and choose more options. If not already selected, choose the trend line options, and towards the bottom, select display equation on chart, which gives a mathematical equation for the trend line in the form of y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope of the trend line and b is its y-intercept. We will also typically select display r-squared value on chart. The r-squared value gives us an idea as how good a match the trend line model is to the experimental data. The closer the r-squared value is to 1, the better the match. Excel originally decided to graph volume on the y-axis and mass on the x-axis, which may or may not have been the way I wanted the data plotted. I may have wanted the axes reversed. In other words, graph mass on the y-axis and volume on the x-axis. One way to do that is to right-click on the chart, choose Select Data, under Select Data Source, click on Edit, and then under Edit Series, type in my series X values and my series Y values that I want, or more simply, click on this icon, and then select the column B values for the X values, and in a similar fashion, select the column A values for the Y values. Click on OK twice, and Excel has now generated a new plot with now mass on the y-axis and volume on the x-axis. Notice that even though my numbers have changed, the labels have not. So update the y-axis label to what it now is, which is mass in grams, and likewise change the x-axis label to volume in milliliters. By changing how the graph was plotted, notice that the trend line equation automatically updated to reflect those changes.